Cough. Cough is one of the commonest symptoms met with in general practice, and most of the cases are of short duration, that is 3 to 4 days. Such coughs are usually due to common colds leading to pharyngitis or laryngitis and sometimes bronchitis. And they respond rapidly when treated with an antibiotic, antihistaminic and cough syrup. Now, which antibiotic to prescribe for simple coughs is always a question. There is a very wide range of antibiotics available, and a different antibiotic will be found to work better in different localities. So you have to decide from experience which antibiotic works in your locality, and then you will prefer that. For mild cases, you may give erythromycin or roxithromycin, or ampicillin cloxacillin or amoxicillin cloxacillin combinations, or ciprofloxacin or sparfloxacin. For severe cases, use second and third generation cephalosporins, azithromycin or lomefloxacin. Injection penicillin given after a test dose is a very effective drug against respiratory infections. Now we shall see what to look for when you examine this patient who complains of cough. The first thing I ask is whether the cough is dry or productive, and whether it is associated with a wheezing sound. If the cough is productive, I ask about the color and amount of expectoration, and whether it is white, frothy, yellow of infection or red with blood. If the cough is dry, I give a codeine preparation like Linctus codeine or fencedil syrup. Whereas if there is expectoration, I will prescribe an expectorant like Soventol expectorant. If expectoration is yellow or foul smelling, which indicates infection, then I will give a higher antibiotic. If there is history of colds and throat pain, it suggests pharyngitis. And if there is a change in the voice or flat voice, there is associated laryngitis. Now examine the patient and auscultate the chest carefully for RALS, ronchi and bronchial breath sounds. Ronchi or wheezing sound means bronchospasm, so prescribe bronchodilators. And if you hear RALS or bronchial or cavity breath sounds, then ask for an X-ray of the chest. Now I will tell you about some peculiar types of cough. If the patient complains of severe pain on one side of the chest on coughing or on deep inspiration, it is very suggestive of pleuritis. If you auscultate carefully, you will hear harsh rubbing sound of the pleural rub. This is another patient who needs to be X-rayed immediately along with HBWBC and ESR. Then, if a patient gets sudden bout of cough after lying down, think of a post-nasal drip, where a drop of posterior nasal discharge falls on the larynx in supine lying down position and there is a violent bout of cough. Take a tongue depressor and a good torch and observe the uvula, whether there is any inflammation of the uvula and posterior pharyngeal wall, and whether any mucus secretions are seen behind the soft palate. Then, if the cough has a very husky sound with hoarseness of voice, especially in an elderly patient, and it does not cure with a 5-day course of antibiotic, then don't delay. Refer immediately to a ENT surgeon for laryngoscopy. Carcinoma of larynx can be detected early only if you have a high degree of suspicion for elderly patients with cough and hoarse voice. If the patient complains of cough only at night, or the cough is much more at night, then ask whether there is associated wheezing, because cough due to bronchospasm will usually be more at night when the weather is cold. History of wheezing is very important, because you examine the patient in daytime when there is less or no bronchospasm, so you may not hear any ronchi. But in general, cough will be noticed more at night when it is quiet all around and everyone is at home to hear it. Secondly, in daytime when one is working, cough is consciously suppressed, At night, when the throat muscles and chest are relaxed, cough always increases. Now we will come to the treatment of cough. For simple cough of short duration, give one antibiotic like erythromycin or cefalexin. If the cough is dry, give a codeine or dextromethorphan preparation like fencedil. And if the cough is productive with expectoration, give an expectorant. If there is associated fever, give paracetamol. And if there is colds, give anti-cold preparation like tab-vicoril or rhinostat. Then talk to the patient about diet and general care. Advise to take hot drinks like tea, coffee, hot water or soups 5 to 6 times a day. Advise steam inhalations 2 to 3 times per day. Adding tincture benzoin or Vicks or Amrutanjan to the water will be of additional benefit. If the throat is congested and painful, advise warm salt water gargles which will soothe the inflamed throat. If the patient has a habit of smoking, instruct him to stop smoking. Lastly, if you notice that the patient is not covering his or her mouth while coughing, instruct to cover the mouth with hand or handkerchief to prevent the spread of infection to other family members. Regarding diet, till the cough is cured, avoid cold chilled food from refrigerator, no cold drinks, no ice cream. Avoid fried foods like vada, pakoda, namkins and potato chips. Take soft food, non-spicy vegetables and lot of hot drinks. Next, we will consider a situation where you have given the treatment, cough does not respond in 2 to 3 days and the patient comes back. Then what do you advise? Number 1, start a higher antibiotic like azithromycin 250 mg BD or cefuroxime or lomefloxacin. Give injectable form for 2 to 3 days if the cough is severe. Number 2, give a short course of steroid like prednisolone 5 mg TDS for 3 days. Theoretically speaking, steroids are not recommended. But a short course of 3 days is often used by most practitioners for a quick relief. Of course, do not give it to a patient who has hyperacidity, diabetes or hypertension, and never give a prolonged course for more than 3 days. If the cough has not responded to treatment, auscultate carefully for ronchi by asking the patient to take deep breaths through open mouth. And lastly, suggest to the patient that if he does not respond in another 2-3 days, you will ask for investigations, that is HBWBC and X-ray of the chest. The main question here is, after how many days will you decide that the cough is not responding and you have to ask for investigations? You could always give a week's trial with stronger antibiotic before asking for an X-ray. But in general practice, you can't wait too long. Otherwise, the patient may go to another doctor. And suppose he gets an X-ray and finds something, he will say you have missed the diagnosis. So if the patient has not responded in first 3 days, make a suggestion positively that if there is no response in another 3 days, you will ask for investigations. If the cough is decreasing, wait and watch. If cough is increasing or not responding, get the investigations. And if the patient is too anxious, get the X-ray early. So here we will consider what are the indications for asking for an X-ray of the chest. Firstly, when there is no response to a full course of antibiotic. Secondly, when the duration of cough is more than 15 days. Thirdly, when the cough is associated with chest pain, high fever or breathlessness. And of course, when there are RALs or abnormal breath sounds on auscultation, you must ask for an X-ray. Let me stress again that for every case of cough for more than 15 days, you must ask for an X-ray of the chest. Because the incidence of tuberculosis is so high in our country that it should always be suspected and ruled out. Secondly, you should also ask for a WBC count. And if the eosinophil count is high, more than 8%, then treat eosinophilia and the cough will respond. Give tabhetrazan 1 TDS for 21 days and tabhisolone 5 mg BD for 10 days.